The best stories in life come from the unknown, the unexpected, the random person that you cross paths with at the most unexpected moment of your day. Those are the stories that hold the most value to us because we didn't plan it out. Have you ever heard someone say to live your life like a movie? To imagine this camera crew following you around your entire life to promote you to live a better life. Have you ever heard of that? Well, movies are planned out. Before the movie is filmed, the directors have planned out the script, they've planned out each action scene, they've planned out the takeaway, the moments of struggle. Where a documentary is different is that none of it is planned out. Oh, okay, they'll develop a vision for it. But for the most part, we're kind of just throwing shit at the wall and seeing what happens, right? And I think that is so much more impactful. And the reason why I've been considering this and just thinking about it is because last week on my last video, I got to interview a buddy of mine who worked on a full feature-length documentary. In this case, this documentary was about a guy who was running across the Australian continent, which is pretty damn far if you ask me. But there was one thing that he said behind the scenes that has just stuck out to me.
We didn't have anything planned. All I knew when we started was he's going to run from point A to point B across the continent. We weren't really able to plan anything because we didn't know how the weather was going to be. We didn't know where exactly we were going. We were also changing the track, the path in between. Like, you had to be very, very versatile, very flexible. Only thing I was really planning was getting all the footage and then sorting out the rest later. Because that's what documentary is about sometimes, you know? It's not like we are planning a film. It's more like I'm just going with this guy and I'm capturing everything that's going to happen. And then I'll see what I can do with it.
And I was thinking, like, how beautiful is that? Like, that's an analogy for life. Go through your life just capturing moments and sort through it later. Sort through it later through reflection. We can't control the storms of life. We can't control how we feel all the time, which I think gives you a little bit of freedom, right? Which gives you a little bit of, okay, I don't always have to feel a certain way in order to do something. I don't always have to have the perfect plan in order to start. And I think that this can keep us stuck. I'm definitely speaking from experience here because there were so many times in my life that I would imagine me building a brand or building a business and just living my life in daydream mode, thinking that I had to have all these ducks in a row in order to take the first step. And I think that that definitely kept me stuck. And so the main reason why I wanted to make this video is because I know that there's someone out there. Could be you watching. It could be, you know, something that you're daydreaming about that you feel like you just have to have another person to help you, or you have to have this amount of money to get started, or you have to figure out what the final destination looks like before you even take your first step. And while that might be, you know, wise to consider, if it's getting to the point where you aren't taking action because of those overthinking thoughts, then who ultimately gets the shit into the stick? You. And who doesn't live out the story that you're hoping to live out? You. Like, what if you could just live your life like a documentary? Oh my God. This is like almost comical. I swear to God, I'm not trying to do this on purpose. What if you could live your life like a documentary to the point where, like, you knew what direction you wanted to go and you start running in that direction, but you realize that there's going to be pain, there's going to be mistakes, you're going to hit a roadblock, you're going to stumble on a rock, and that's okay because it's kind of the point. Because what happens after we stumble on that rock? We learn from our mistakes by maybe not dragging our feet as much, by picking up our knees a little bit, or knowing when to take a break, when to rest, when to reflect, to sort through the footage, and just course correct along the way. Like I said in the beginning, every great story stems from something that was completely unexpected. So if we can lean into that, lean into this space that's unknown, and just perform and push ourselves in this direction that we feel like is going to mean something in the end, that's all we need in order to just take the step. If you feel like there could be something here, why not go for it? If you are daydreaming about something, there's a good reason why you're daydreaming about it. Like, you don't just daydream about, like, painting on a wall, right? Unless you want to paint walls. You don't just daydream about the next, YouTube video that you're gonna make unless you want to make YouTube videos. So my advice here is to always get your answer. Like, if something is floating around in your mind that you are considering doing, you've always thought, oh, how cool would it be to just make videos about cooking? Or how cool would it be to finally go to Australia and run across the continent? Get your answer. You know, don't let that just float in the back of your mind, because if we do that for too long, it's gonna become too late. You're gonna lose time. You're gonna lose the physical, like, mobility to perform, depending on whatever it is. Like, you can't be an 80-year-old painting walls. I mean, unless that's your thing, like, shit, go for it. I'm not saying you can't do anything, but don't allow yourself to stay stuck. Don't allow yourself to overcomplicate the process, because if I could go back and have a conversation with my younger self in moments where I was thinking like, oh, I need the perfect plan, I would just tell myself, you cannot fully plan this out, dude. There is no fucking way you can plan out every single little detail that's gonna happen in your life. But you can create a vision, and you can aim towards that vision, and you can take small steps toward that. This is why I recommend that if you have no clue where you're going in life, really, really, really imagine yourself as the 50-year-old version of yourself. Think about what a day in that life looks like. And I'm saying this from like a picture perfect mindset. What do you do from start to finish? What time do you go to bed? Why do you go to bed at this time? What time do you wake up? And why do you wake up at this time? And what are you filling your days with? You have all the freedom in the world, all the money that you need, all the time. Okay, maybe not the time, because we're all on the same page there. But you have everything you need. You have everything you could ever ask for. What do you then spend your time doing? Because that is what truly matters. And if you need help with that, I did actually create a free resource that I'll leave in the description that you can go fill out and gain clarity on whatever your vision is. Because for the longest time in my personal life, I was just floating about. You know, I'm just sitting back on this little floaty in the middle of the pool, just soaking in the sun, not having a fucking clue what I was doing with my life. And it wasn't until I realized, like, at the age 50, like, if I have all these ducks in a row and I want to spend my time doing all this stuff, then I should start doing some of those things now. I should start taking small baby steps towards creating that life right now. I'm a little bit over halfway there, but that is enough time for me to take action in my life and to create something that's going to mean something in the end for me. Because even at the age 50, man, ideally, you know, we're going to like 70, 80, like another 20 years just living your perfect lifestyle. That sounds amazing. So let's aim for that and not distract ourselves right now with all these flashy objects, because ultimately what ends up happening is that if we're constantly running away from boredom, we end up creating a boring life. And that sounds fucking miserable to me. I do not want to be on my deathbed thinking about that. And what's beautiful about living your life as a documentary is that the story will naturally unfold and build something meaningful for you. It will naturally take care of that. You do not have to plan it out. All you need to do is just stay focused, stay consistent, you know, take your rest, take your time off whenever you need it. Don't just fucking do this hustle grind bullshit that we all know is not sustainable, but do things that matter to you. You know, like, this is your life. You have one go at this, and I know we all fucking hear this, but it is always worth remembering that we will all die one day, so that we can have a sense of urgency in our lives to do the meaningful thing that we know will actually make us feel fulfilled. Doing the boring thing now is going to create the life that means something to you later. We all have our bad days. But it's important to lean back on this concept of living your life like a documentary. Look at me, I'm saying it right. So that you can just live out your story. So that you can just embrace the difficult moments, because you know that those difficult moments are gonna make a great story one day. And although in those moments, we're not like, oh my God, I'm so happy I fucking made a mistake, I can't wait to tell this story. You can do the flip side, which is, okay, that mistake happened, I'm not gonna dwell on it. I'm gonna consider what happened and consider what I could have done better, but the worst possible thing I can do for myself is to dwell, and I'm not gonna do that shit, because I know that this is purposeful, like, this is gonna mean something in the end. One thing that has been really helpful for me, because like I said, we all have our bad days, we're going to experience some roadblocks. And for me, that happens quite often with creativity. And in these moments, I think it's useful to have like a little process, like have a process for going after things and have a process for dealing with roadblocks. For me personally, what helps a ton is taking a step back, not trying to force anything. I tried forcing for so long, that shit just does not work. It doesn't work. Forcing anything will just rob the creativity, it will rob the whole story, and it's just it just gets real icky really fast. So take a step back. If you need to extend the deadline, dude, extend it. Like, nobody's gonna die. You're not gonna die. Don't get in the habit of extending the deadline, but don't beat yourself up, man. Like, life is too short to be sitting there fucking banging your head up against the wall because you didn't finish something on time. Go on a walk though. Give yourself space, create some stillness in your life, meditate, just focus on breathing. And that alone will literally help you so fucking much. Every single time I do one of those things, I just like relax and I kind of just take my hands off my throat because it feels like I'm just choking myself. And what makes it worse in these moments is when I try to distract myself because I feel good for a little bit, like doom scrolling. And then next thing I know, I'm choking myself even harder. And I'm like, fuck, I'm like, this is even more difficult to get out of this situation. So just be mindful of what your impulses are. Creating a space where there is no opportunity for distractions, I think is helpful. Like when I go on a walk, I know I'm going on a walk. I'm not gonna sit there and look at my phone as I'm walking. It's just gonna defeat the whole purpose. And also just makes me fucking feel nauseous doing that. I don't know how people do that all the time. But create systems for yourself. Whenever things get tough, what do? I just gave you a couple options, but we're all different. What's the thing that's gonna work for you? I think the main thing here is just to remind yourself to be playful with life. When you're a little kid and you're building a fort or you're doing Legos, you are not worrying about how fucking perfect it looks or how it will look in the end. You're just taking one Lego, putting it on the fucking Lego that you already have, and slowly but surely, you start building this thing, and at the end, you're like, wow, what a great documentary. What a great story this is. But if I'm sitting there like trying to, if I'm like this little kid and I'm not feeling playful and I'm like, I don't want to do it because I don't want to even think about what I'm building, or I don't think I can build the thing I have in my mind. Like, it's not about that. It's about the little, taking the Lego and just stacking the Lego and just seeing what the fuck happens. That is what this whole process is about. And if there's anything I want you to get from this video, is to just be playful with your life. Be playful with the story. Don't worry about the rigid edges of your life, because ultimately you will feel very miserable. Let's just put it that way. It might work for you once or twice, but it is not a sustainable way to live your life. So hopefully this gives you some perspective on just the challenges that you go through in life, or maybe just those daydreams that you have. It is your life, and I don't care what anybody has ever told you or what has happened in the past. You always have the opportunity to redefine yourself and create your future in the way that you want to. I strongly believe that for every single person on this planet. There's always a way. I mean, we've seen stories where the unthinkable has happened. This is your chance. This is your story. This is your documentary. Now go live it out. Go create a story that's gonna make you fucking smile during your last seconds on this earth. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Oh, that was a good one.